Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokemon Ultra Sun Blind Nuzlocke, where I am a complete and utter idiot. If you don't know why, then you didn't watch the last episode. I was fighting Olivia, and we lost Cutlass, because I'm a complete idiot, for no reason other than that. Because I should have, clearly I could have just gone into, did I do this already? What did I do, where the heck was I? Wait a minute, what's this over here? An item. It is a big mushroom, okay, cool. Yeah, I just went into Jacoba and was just fine. So clearly there was no point to go into Cutlass in the first time. I somehow forgot where I was. No, I was going to the Hano Beach area because Faba told me to meet him there. Yeah, that's right. Oh, Grand Resort. I believe... Yeah, the Grand Resort we're supposed to meet him. Is there anything cool down here? No, no, I can't surf over here. Sticker! Yeah, 30 stickers! And to the east is the beach where you can get where you can do the Pukumuku thing, I believe. I would assume that's still in the game. I don't know why they get rid of that. Because it's a neat money-making thing. Hano Beach. Oh, and there's new place for a new encounter. All right. But anyway, yeah, you may be looking at my team on the sidebar and wonder why some people might be missing. Someone specifically is missing. And, hey, a Sandy Ghast. Oh, I thought I could actually just catch the Sandy Ghast. But no. I don't understand the purpose of these Pokemon. Wants to play more with you. I want to leave. Bye. What happens if you do that long enough? Do you get the Pokemon or something? Because if you could, I'd let you get a Sandy Ghast. Because I believe in the sand, it's a very high chance of Staryu and a low chance of Sandy Ghast. And in the water, probably boring water stuff. So I guess I'll try to get Sandy Ghast. But if it's Staryu, I'm going to catch Staryu instead because I'm totally fine with Staryu. No, it is Sandy Ghast! Oh my god! Let's not screw this up. Alright, we got Jacoba up front. Is that a little overpowered for this? No, I don't think so. That should resist Rock Tomb, right? Yeah, I think. Or at least it's not stab, so it shouldn't do a whole lot. Yeah, perfect. What's it gonna use? Sand Attack? Oh, that's not very nice. Alright, well, if that was not very effective, I could probably be okay with a Bulldoze as well. That probably shouldn't hurt. I just realized I have two attacks on Jacoba that lower speed. Oh, well. Oh, speaking of Bulldoze. We have plenty of time to talk about this because there's probably going to be a bunch of dialogue in a minute where I'll have time to explain things. So hold your horses for a minute while I catch this Pokemon I want to catch. Sandy Ghast! Yeah! I'm really getting much better with my encounters in this playthrough as opposed to the Sun Nuzlocke. Which is very nice. But why aren't I using them, right? And why am I using this old Pokemon? Well, there's a couple reasons. It gives me experience. Everyone level 30. I'll get back to that. Hold on. What a nickname for Sandy Ghast. Hold on. This is Balisong. Why that? I have no idea. It was a name that was recommended by somebody. I'm assuming it's a type of sword or blade. Water compaction. Boosts water defense stats when hit with water moves, but it'll almost kill it when it gets by a water move, so. Alright, cool! And docile, all equal. Or neutral angel, I like it. Alright, send to a box. Alright, back to explaining. Let's look at my party, shall we? Everyone's level 30. Jacoba, Ipe, and Claymore, that's probably pretty obvious. And then we got three new people. We got Kadachi, who was an Eevee and is now a Jolteon. That was the one, because I got a Thunderstone earlier, and even if I didn't, I got to the shop, I could buy stones. And I did a Mantine game, this should be here. I did the Mantine serving, and I got Shockwave and Signal Beam for moves, because his moves kind of sucked. So there's that, and then I got Estok, the Alolan Diglett who was before, and now he's Alolan Dugtrio. Because I think they're a good Pokemon, and we're coming to an electric trial on the next island, so couldn't hurt to have, was my logic at least. And then we got Dao, who was basically my replacement for Cutlass for a water type. Because I like Tentacruels, they're really good, and honestly, and I want using Tentacruel now, because if it dies, I won't be too sad, because I've used Tentacruels before. That's why I'm using it now. So, you guys might be thinking, wait a minute, what about Shamshir? Why did you box Shamshir? Well, guys, I have to be honest right now. Oh, wait, is that a sticker? No, dude, get move. No, move. Get off. I want to get that sticker. Can you come over here? Hello, come on. Ha ha! Sticker. Cool. I didn't know that. That was neat. So I asked in my Discord before I did this, and everyone seemed to be okay with it. I asked, am I allowed to look up move sets or level up moves of Pokemon I currently own? Because I'm not looking up spoilers of the game or future stuff that might impede or that might give me an advantage or something. And what's this? This is different. All right, you are the famous Chewster. Chew. That's different. Hold that thought. What is this gonna? Is it gonna be anything weird? Oh, Tacoba's fine. Why not? I remember this guy before. I just don't remember Pikachu. Shoo. This event wasn't here, but I remember that guy. I remember that Pikachu sitting there. You make my household name with a massive success. Your latest film, Chewster. Rumors that you were in Alola were true after all. How are you spending your time off? What were you in Alola here now? I must ask you to respect Master Chewster's privacy and let him vacation in peace. He will not be taking interviews at this time. What? But everyone's just dying to know more about the famous Chewster's private life. You've got to spill. Please, we've asked once nicely. Get out of my face. Shoo. Let's step in. Yeah, leave Pikachu alone. You went over here too? This is my school. I'm not letting you have it. Okay, what is it? Why does the teacher want to interview you? Oh, reporter? Really, guys? Okay, now can I say that they're being lazy with the trainer sprites or models? The same model is used for teacher, reporter, that whatever the heck she was in the Mealy Mealy Meadow, I forgot at this point. Oh, hey, Meal Tank, good. Tacoba, you be good for this. Whoever the heck, I forgot that trainer class, what they were. And then there was, that family. There was a teacher and preschooler, but they called them family. Was it all that? Remember that? Same model for all three of those. Four. Same model. Come on, guys. They could do better than that. Anyway. Let me see the end of this cutscene before I go back to my explaining of what I was doing. Because when I tend to explain things during cutscenes, I tend to miss stuff. I don't think this is going to be an important one, but wow, but the freedom of the press! Thank you for helping us in that rather sticky situation. Chew! See, Mr. Chewster is also appreciative of your assistance. Chew. What are you sure? If you insist. Wasn't he give me something as thanks? Master Chewster, for you. The Pekinium Z. Of course. Well, thanks. I appreciate that, even though I can't use it. Pikachu. Choo, 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 choo! Choo-choos. That's it. That's Pekinium Z pose. Really just stand there like a Pikachu would look cute? That's the choo. Oh, wow. Very intricate pose. All right. Now, I'm gonna assume a lot of this is gonna be the same because we're not at Ula Ula yet, so go back to explaining. I looked up movesets, guy. I looked up my level up moves for Charjabug and Vikavolt. Because I was worried that if I level up too high as Charjabug, I would miss out on moves as Vikavolt. And I was right. At level 31, meaning in one more level, Charjabug learns X Scissor, and Vikavolt learns Bug Buzz. Basically, physical and special variants of the same strong bug move, in essence. But Vikavolt is a special attacker. Bug Buzz will be much better. And because the move reminder, which I also asked about in my Discord, is still at the very freaking end of the game, right before the Elite Four, there's no chance of me getting Bug Buzz back until that point, unless I evolve Charge Bug at exactly level 31. Right? But wait a minute, I just realized, doesn't he have all... Crap, maybe I've already leveled up too high. He's at 30 at the moment. Because if I get to 31, he also gets Thunderbolt upon evolution, because that's a new thing to add in the 7th gen. By the way, I'm skimming this conversation I'm reading, it's exactly the same as Sun and Moon, so you're not missing out on anything. I think this is the perfect time to explain that stuff. Speaking of Vix, what was I just saying? Yeah, I learned Thunderbolt by level, by evolution. Will I learn both Thunderbolt and Bug Buzz? Because if I don't, then that's really, really disappointing. Because I would have gotten both a 31 and... That's really disappointing. I hope I didn't level up too high. Maybe I should have gotten to only 29 for Shamshir. But I got everyone to 30. I wanted everyone to 30. There's also another handful of Pokemon in my box at level 30. Just for a preemptive or proactive training in case someone dies middle of an episode, you know? This is Aether Paradise. Yep, this is the same thing so far. So I'm gonna go to the assumption we're probably gonna end up fighting a Nihiligo again. And this is probably gonna be exactly the same as before. Physically created others' favorite purpose, Pokeballs for conservation. You can't use them all. Yep, same things. See, that was my logic. If I'm using the Shamshir at the moment, he will undoubtedly grow to level 31. Because Blush Mountain is still decently far away. I mean, it's coming up. Don't worry, it is coming up. But he only has to grow one more level, and we've already passed the point where I learned Bug Buzz as Vikavolt. So that was my logic. That's why I replaced Shamshir temporarily with Kodachi, and why then Dial the Tentacruel was replacement for Cutlass, and then Estoc the Dugtrio was my replacement for whoever else died. Barboach, Swihander. But more so because it was all more so a replacement for Flissa, Mudbray, who died to Sudowoodo before Lurantis. Because I need a ground type for the upcoming electric one. So, but yeah, I also trained up a couple others in my box. I trained up, what did I name it? Yatagon, I think I named it. Yatagon the Boldor, it was Roggenrola, then I got to Boldor, and then I traded to my sun version for Gigalith. So that's now Gigalith. I also trained up my Rockruff, my event Rockruff, Scimitar, who is now the Dusk Lycanroc. Oh, neat! Dupiter and Blossom. That's the only difference so far here. It's around 11. Oh, yeah, they didn't take this out. They didn't take this out, apparently. You're still canonically 11 in this game, which I think is stupid, because anybody who is not 11 playing this game is suddenly no longer very connected with their character. You are 100% 11. If they don't tell your age, which I like in other games, it's kind of ambiguous. You're kind of whatever age you feel like you are. Within reason, of course. But no, you're flat out 11 in this game. Yeah. Well, yeah, Dusk Lycanroc, again, I don't have in my party right now because I'm afraid of getting swept by someone and losing all the good Pokemon I want to use. That's why I always want to have some good Pokemon that I want to use on backup. And yeah, Corsola gets eaten by Toxapex, and they're somehow trying to save Corsolas, which I find weird. It's just nature. Toxapex eats Corsola. That's it. That's the circle of life. If you take away Corsola from the environment, take away from the wild, there's less Corsola for Toxapex to eat, which makes Toxapex probably have less food, and they'll probably die out, and there'll be a shortage of Toxapex. Which, then again, maybe they're an invasive species that shouldn't even be there. Who knows? You can also play with a Starmie. Really. Starmie is staring at you. Oh my god. Stare at it. Stare at it! Starmie. Dot, dot, dot. Staring at you. Bye. Does anyone really know the point of that in the game? Being able to pet or play with Pokemon randomly? I mean, it's nothing wrong with it being in the game. It's just so unnecessary to me. And I will fill you with my love. I wonder if Lucibeen's still evil in this game, or if they're changing that part of the story. And so far, everything's pointing towards it being a yes, but maybe in a different way? I don't know. But how? Private island? Yeah, we somehow have a private island, because we have lots of money somehow. Yeah, I'm like a mother, all these poor women shower them with love, even with distant worlds that I want to control, and yeah, I'm over 40. Yeah, well, you definitely look way older than them. So, I don't know why Hal thinks she's that much older than 11, because that's actually weird to think that. She looks like more so in her late 20s, which, yeah, being over 40, that's impressive, but still, she does not look like just a little bit over the age of Hal and Knuckleblade. So, What was that? Oh, is the Ultra Wormhole opening up? Maybe it's gonna be a different Ultra Beast. Maybe it'll be like that Poi Pole or whatever that the Ultra Recon Squad had. Just make it a little different. But then again, if it is Nihiligo, that might imply that Lusamine still wants to fuse with one and be evil. Yeah, it's Nihiligo. Surprise! Plot twist! And my character's acting surprised. Good, wow, my character's a good actor, suddenly, even though he has the same facial expression in every other situation. Long black screen. Take your time. Take your time, game. No, we're not in any hurry. You are, you come from the distant world? Venomeno! Oh, it actually says things now. Instead of brrr. You poor creature. Okay, well, I know what its type is now. Tacoba, you're still up front. It's poison rock. So ground is... Oh, wait, ground. Oh, I could have used... I forgot I had S-Stock for a minute. Because I have bulldoze on Tacoba. Oh, well, whatever. We'll switch out if it becomes a problem. We'll switch out if, like, I get too hurt. Defense rose sharply. Well... That shouldn't be too big a deal because it already has, like, ridiculously high special defense, so... It honestly doesn't matter which one we're using, physical or special, because it's really defensive either way. Venoshock. Ow. Oh, we're fine. Boom, boom. Yeah, we're fine. A lower speed will probably go first now when you're dead. Right? Yeah. Oh, no, we didn't go first. Crap. Oh, well. Yeah, Tacoma's a little slow, but that's alright. That's why I'm moving with the Quick Claw, and why two of its moves lower enemy speed. So, it's a good strategy. Or do I not have that anymore? I switched around my items a couple times off screen, because I was really debating on what items I want to be able to use. Maybe I give him the Expert Belt, actually. Oh, well. Because I gave Ipe the Aviolite, that's right. Because Ipe is the only one on my team that's not fully evolved yet. So, I thought I might as well. So, it's true, I still need that Pokemon. I need to get it back, because I want to be evil and combine with a Nihiligo. Oh, hey, Dulse! An Ultra Beast is now. Came from the other end of an Ultra Wormhole, and hey, they have eyes, suddenly! They didn't have eyes before. They were, like, wearing, like, goggles or something, I think. It's being for another world. The world you know is Ultra Space. Seriously, what's with the getup? These are my guests, the Ultra Recon Squad. Okay, so you do know each other. Foundation advice regarding the Ultra Beasts. Why don't you introduce yourselves? I already know who they are. Dulse. And I'm Sussy! Ultra Wormholes? Question mark? Pretending I don't know what they are? We came to a lower region from another world by passing through an Ultra Wormhole. We came from the world of darkness, whose light was stolen by the one called Necrozma. Ooh. His Necrozma was, like, unbelievably strong. It can wield light however it likes, and sure, it does run wild sometimes, but also shares this mysterious light it has with others, too. So, it's extremely powerful and is nice sometimes, but evil other times. But everything will be fine! If this Necrozma, or even an Ultra Beast like the one we just saw, should come to this world, live for another, the other Foundation will be prepared to protect the light of Alola. Rest easy, you would not need to worry about a thing. Hmm. Really? Okay, so what I'm getting here is that Lusamine is still gonna be evil. This coverage looks the same. Just, she's now getting help from an outside source. Not just from their own internal experiments of the Aether Foundation, they're also getting help from the Ultra Recon Squad, because they're actually from the Ultra Beast Realm, and they know more about it. So... But maybe when we get to the part where it normally, where we come back here and fight the Aether Foundation and they're evil and stuff, maybe instead of it being she releases Nihiligo and all the Ultra Beasts everywhere, it actually releases Necrozma, which sucks away all of Alola's light, and it becomes dark, and we have to go to the Ultra Realm to stop Necrozma and give the light back. How accurate am I for the story? Some Alasadas for how? And some of those, I think, you know what I mean? Yeah, and it's like, yeah, I still get that! Hooray! That's a good TM. I don't know if anyone I have right now can learn it, but... Oh well, that's fine. Wondrous adventures? We will have wondrous adventures, yes. We will! Thank you, Miss Wick! All right. Hey, wait a minute. Are we gonna we're gonna find Howl as soon as we get off the boat, aren't we? Crap! And he starts with a Torracat. So, and I'm starting with Tacoba, and he's weak to fire. Crap. How can we skip our fight for a little bit? Can I, like, heal first or destroy my team? The world is just way too big! And why are we not sitting by the window? Why did we pick the two aisle seats? Pick the window seats. Clearly, my character wants to look out the window. Maybe my character doesn't want to speak up because he doesn't say anything ever. Maybe Hal liked the aisle seat for some reason. Because he has to keep getting up to use the bathroom from eating all the malasadas all the time. Maybe that's it. Makes sense. Should I already eat the whole thing? Yeah, see what I mean? Yeah. Anyway. Oh, so wait, we don't get the Mantine surf for the next island? Oh. Maybe there's a different beach on Ula Ula we can Mantine surf? Okay. We just took a boat to this island. That's a little boring. Oh, well. I guess that means we can start the next island stuff sooner. Because I don't need to show Mantine surfing on screen anymore. You guys get what the gist of it is. And I do it just for fun off screen for move Twitter moves and stuff. So that's cool. All right, well, we're in Melee City now. The other Japanese city. Because, you know, Koni Koni was also Japanese/Chinese. And this one's definitely Japanese. Land ahoy! All right, Terra Foot Firma Underground Foot thing. I read that really wrong. Oh, don't battle me yet, please. Was it totally different than players are Melee Lurk? Color, huh? Doesn't look that different. Why doesn't it want a garden? Guess we'll find out when we get there, right? Are you not battling me, Hal? You're not battling me. Island Pokedex, yes, thanks, Rotom. Is there anything over here? Yeah, sticker. Is he not battling me? Is he, this maybe as I walk down the road there? Well, either way, I thank you. Start with Dao. Because chances are he's going to start with Torracat, based on all of his previous battles we've had with him. Anything down here at the dock? Like a sticker? No. Nope, no stickers. Darn. Alright, let's see what's in here real quick. I'll skip this if there's nothing here. Alright, yeah, all that was in there was that nugget. That's fine. Alright, let's go this way. How are you gonna fight me? Are you gonna fight me as I approach the Pokemon Center? No? Oh, there you are. I see you. Alright, well, cool. He lets me even go to the Pokemon Center first if I wanted. So, okay, that's cool. Alright, let's have a battle, sure. Alright, let's go full powered on this one. Alright. Alright, Hal, whatever you say. You're going down, newbie. Alright, Pokemon Center, Hal. Five Pokemon? Okay, Hal. We get it. Calm down. You... Five Pokemon. Okay, at this point in the other game, he only had three. He had a starter. At this point is when he actually got his Eeveelution, and then he had Raichu. That's it. So he's got... one of those is his Noibat. He then's got one new one as well. My God. Okay. They definitely stepped up How in this game. In terms of difficulty. And honestly, that was my one gripe with How. I love his personality as a friend character. I just didn't think he was all that great of a rival. But honestly, I think they stepped that up quite a bit, making him a good rival as well as a good friend character. And I'm really glad I did not flinch there. Good job, Dao. Although I can't really use you for the rest of the battle now, can I? Because that did a lot of damage to you. Oh well, Raichu. Okay. That is a job for Estak. In fact, Estak's the only one who resists psychic, now that I think about it. So, you're gonna have to do this. Okay, good. That didn't do over half. I was kind of worried, because Alolan Raichu is pretty strong, and Psychic's a pretty decently strong move. So, let's bulldoze it. If this doesn't kill it, we may have a problem. Then again, maybe I can hope that I lowered its speed enough from bulldoze. Ah, we got it! Yes! Good job, Estak! Ah, welcome to the team officially. Alright, Leafeon. Well, that's not super effective against me. But, Alright, Estak, let's get out. Let's go to Claymer! But yeah, guys, I think that he's even better in this game than Sun and Moon. Although, because the cutscenes have been a little different than in Sun and Moon, we did miss out on a couple things, a couple lines of his that I like, or a couple moments with him that I like. Like, the one I think of offhand is the... when they're on the boat with Kukui, he makes fun of Lily's hat, but... I mean, whatever. It's a small trade-off for him being a slightly better rival. I'm totally fine with this. Are you gonna heal with a potion? Because I hope you do, because Leafeon's not a threat. Nope. Okay, then I have a feeling you're not gonna use potions. Good rival. You're a good rival, Hao. You don't use potions. I appreciate that. I really do appreciate that. And yay, hello for Estoc! And Tauros! Tauros? That's interesting. It's kind of a random Pokemon to give him. But alright, Tauros. Tacoba, that's all you. That's really interesting. Tauros is the new Pokemon they added for him. Alright, you're probably not gonna do a whole lot to me unless you have a special attack hidden in there. Nope, you just have Horn Attack. That's your best move right now. I'm assuming Tauros is gonna be a lot difficult, lot more difficult later, because I feel like Tauros is a decently good Pokemon. So I'm not surprised they gave him one, because it's a good Pokemon. It's just kind of random. I don't know. And then Noibat! I guess we could switch for that. I guess the only one left is Kodachi that I haven't used yet in this battle, and Epe can't fight Noibat. And Tacoba's weak to flying, so yeah, might as well switch to Kodachi, just to resist a flying move. If this is a mistake, well, I can switch to, yeah, Wing Attack. I can switch to someone else, I'll be fine. Probably Estoc could be okay as well. Although Estoc's almost dead, isn't he? Never mind. Shockwave! Yeah, for some reason, Jolteon only learned Thunder Shock by level up. I had to teach Shockwave via, the Move Tutor move from the Mantine Surfing. I don't even think he learns Thunderbolt by level up, if I remember correctly. He only learns Thunder by level up later. So I'll have to get the TM for Thunderbolt at some point. A Lycan EMZ? Huh? Lycan Rock has a Z move? Okay, that must be something new to Ultra Sun or Ultra Moon that I didn't know about. You mad that I still don't seem to be getting all that much stronger? How? Okay, how? Don't beat yourself. You're getting a lot stronger. Sure, me and my partner ought to be like totally in sync with one another. We'll get there, buddy. Now I guess we should go try to track him versus Googly and Mealy Garden, right? Yes. Yes. Alright, I want to see what that Lycan EMZ does. Upgrades Lycan at Stone Edge? And it was Voltak, that's what I thought for that. I did not know Lycanroc has its own Z-move. I mean, I can't use it in this playthrough, but that's really neat. So, alright, I'm gonna go heal, or did I already get healed by Hao? Yeah, Hao did heal me. Alright, then let's be on our way. Let's go to Melee Garden and get us a new encounter there. Or at least attempt to. Oh, wait a minute. Can I go clothes shopping first? Or is Lily gonna stop? Lily's gonna stop me. Dang it. I remember being upset about that in the last game. That Lily stops you from going that way until you do the stuff in Melee Garden. They serve tea somewhere in Melee Garden. High tea! That's a reference to my Miitopia playthrough, for those that don't know. Alright, and now, he's conveniently blocking the most direct way to get there, just to force you to take the long way and go through the whole garden. Hey, what's in this grass here? I know you can catch a Raquinid in here, which would be really nice. And instead we get Poliwhirl. I already denied Poliwag earlier in the game, didn't I? Pretty sure I denied Poliwag in, Brooklyn Hill. And then we ended up catching Morlow, who we named Gladius. So, yeah, I've already denied Poliwhirl, can't get him even if I wanted to. So, alright, what else? A rock would be really great. Oh, Cottony! Huh. Cottony. Darn it. While I do like Cottony a lot, and I've used them a couple times before, Whimsicott's really good, though, in my opinion. I love Cottony. He's really good. Darn, now I have made a decision to make. You know, I'm thinking about it. I am going to catch Cottony. I've decided. Or I'm going to try to catch Cottony, at least. My logic is, I know another way when you can get here is Ladian. And Ladian, I don't think you can consider that I've used it before in my Nuzlocke. Because I don't think I have. Legitimately, I don't think I've used Ladian. And I don't want a Ladian. So, I would rather have Cottony than take the chance of getting Ladian versus Araquanid. Araquanid would be amazing, don't get me wrong, and it'd be great to try for him, but if I end up with Ladian, which probably has a higher encounter rate, then I will be stuck with that, and I do not want Ladian. So, I'm totally fine with Cottony, so I'm not upset whatsoever. Because I do like cottony a lot. So, alright! We got us a cottony! I just hope it has Prankster, or else it's kinda worthless. Not really worthless, just not as good as it could be. As opposed to the rock and roll that we got, which is basically useless because it doesn't have, sturdy. Alright, nickname for cottony. This is Cleaver. Why Cleaver? Because I feel like being a prankster, you're kinda clever. You know? Probably doesn't even have Prankster, does he? Nope, Infiltrator. Yep. Okay, fine. He's Cleaver because he cleverly bypasses Reflect and Substitute and stuff. Yeah. Okay, send to a box. Bye, Cleaver. All right. Well, that was good. Good, not great. All right, I think we're just going to fight this preschool, then we'll be done with today's episode. Today's Pokemon Day! Every day is Pokemon Day. Stupid little girl. Don't you know anything about the world? Preschooler Nancy. You've got a Cleffa. And that is going to die. Because we have a poison attack. Why did Cleffa at this point in the game? I know it's a preschooler who has, like, supposed to have, like, low-leveled stuff. And, like, low-evolution stuff, but still. Eh, whatever. And special events fell, and you suck. You suck massively. Yeah. Alright, we'll just switch out. I don't feel like sitting around and waiting for that to wear off. Go to EP. Epe. Epe should be evolving soon. I know it's in the early 30s, Fomantis evolves, which I gotta be honest, I think is a little too late in the game. Because, Fomantis kind of sucks at this point. Like, compared to my other stats, on my other my other Pokemon, Fomantis is without a doubt the worst in terms of its stats. So I feel like it should have evolved earlier, and like, I think it should have evolved in the later 20s, personally. I know it's not that big a difference, but it kind of is when you're, I don't know, trying to stay consistent with what the opponents are and stuff. And I'm gonna go back and heal, and then we'll be in the next episode, where we'll continue looking in Melee Garden, talk to Kukui, and then we'll be on our way to the Electra Trial. So, hope you look forward to that. Thank you for watching, and as always, rock on.